हेलो एंड वेलकम टू द ऑटो टुडे यूट्यूब चैनल। माय नेम इज रूप एंड विद मी इज द 2021 होंडा अमेज। नाउ इन इट्स सेकंड जनरेशन द अमेज इज अ क्रूशियल मॉडल इन होंडाज लाइनअप इन द कंट्री। इट्स वन ऑफ द बेस्ट सेलर्स एंड सो फार हैज सोल्ड क्लोज टू 4.5 लाख यूनिट्स इन द कंट्री। फॉर 2021 होंडा हैज गिवन इट अ फेसलिफ्ट। व्हाट आर द चेंजेस, व्हाट हैव दे एडेड, वेल वी आर गोइंग टू टेल यू ऑल ऑफ दोस थिंग्स। बट एज ऑलवेज बिफोर वी गेट टू दैट, don't forget to subscribe to the channel and please do click on the bell icon so that you get notified every time a video goes up on Auto Today. For the facelift, Honda has focused on sprucing up the exterior to make it a little more premium. To that effect, they've added a new grille with a little more chrome. And next to the grille are these LED projector headlamps along with LED DRLs, and these are automatic. Also new are these LED fog lamps. The facelifted Amaze also comes with new two-tone 15-inch alloy wheels, C-shaped LED tail lamp motif, and chrome garnishing on the rear bumper. This grey color you see here on your screens is a new addition as well. When it comes to the interiors of the 2021 Honda Amaze, changes aren't very significant. In fact, you'll be hard-pressed to notice all the changes. So let me just point them out for you. The dashboard, the door pads and the steering wheel get these silver accents, and that is about it. As far as the changes are concerned, there's nothing else that has changed. You get the same amount of space in the front, in the back. And speaking of space, it is one of the Amaze's key strengths. You get a touchscreen with Android Auto, Apple CarPlay. You get a reverse parking camera, and speaking of the reverse parking camera, there are three view options now instead of that just one standard view. But apart from that, everything else remains the same. You get a climate control system, you get Android Auto, you get Apple CarPlay. There's a analog instrument panel here with a digital display in the middle to give you all the information that you might need while driving. The one thing the Amaze misses out on is maybe a sunroof. It's something that Honda could have added to, you know, enhance the premium appeal of the vehicle. And the other thing the Amaze does not get is rear AC vents. In terms of the engines on offer and transmission options on offer, nothing changes. You get a 1.2 litre petrol motor and a 1.5 litre diesel motor. Both are available with a 5-speed manual transmission or a CVT. The power outputs, the torque outputs, the fuel efficiency rating, everything is exactly as it was before. So there is not much to talk about in that department, but just to jog your memories, the Amaze is a very comfortable car. It takes to our bad roads pretty well. You'll be very comfortable at city speeds, tackling potholes, tackling the less than perfect roads that are thrown at you, and other aspects performance wise it's the diesel that is the punchier one. Of course, it's got more power, more torque, and that does excite you a little more. But the problem with the diesel is it still feels pretty unrefined. It's noisy, and there's a lot of engine noise that filters into the cabin, so that's a bit of a downer. But again, the segment dynamics currently are such that people prefer petrol. Most buyers are for the petrol variant, and the petrol motor does not disappoint in any aspect. Performance is more than adequate. It feels relatively more refined than the diesel, and in general it is decently refined, although at higher speeds there is some wind noise that creeps in and road noise that creeps in. But otherwise, within the city, it's all okay, nothing to complain about. The steering is slightly on the heavier side, but not in a way that will put you off or that will be a deal breaker for you by any measure. So yeah, all in all, the Amaze was and still is a nice car to drive, a nice car to live with, very comfortable in the city, and one that will keep most buyers pretty happy. Honda is offering the Amaze in E, S and VX grades. Pretty much every new feature we've listed out in this video is reserved for the top-end VX grade, which is priced between 8.22 lakh and 11.15 lakh ex-showroom, depending on the variant you pick. The base E grade is priced at 6.32 lakh for the petrol manual and rupees 8.67 lakh for the diesel manual,
Both prices again ex-showroom. The list of changes might not be long, but these additions certainly help enhance the premiumness overall. The Honda Amaze was and remains a very, very sensible pick in the sub-4-meter compact sedan space, and we see no reason why it won't continue being one of the best sellers in the segment.